Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing the Bushwhacker because some of you wanted to see a light Gauss rifle build, and the Bushwhacker is actually a mech that can carry that combination very, very nicely. I really like the looks of it here. Look at the tusks that are sticking out. This is great. Now, we're gonna take two light Gauss rifles, as you can see. Those each deal 8 damage, which is not that great. So, if you really want to snipe, go ahead and take a regular Gauss rifle and some medium lasers. That's the better option, I would say. But again, since you wanted light Gauss play, yeah, you get light Gauss play. The benefit that we have is more range and more DPS, like more damage over time. We have a lower cooldown on the light Gauss rifle, but it needs you to get into a situation where you can constantly shoot, and this is not really for peeking in and out of cover. This is more for constant direct engagements. We also have two Eros small lasers to supplement the build and give us a little bit of extra quote-unquote punch, but yeah, that's basically it. We don't need arms here, so we completely strip them. Arms on a Bushwhacker are completely overrated unless you have weapons in there. You actually can lose them without a problem because your torso is what matters, and it is so slim. That means if you face an enemy straight on, they have a problem shooting you. But if you're getting flanked, you have a pretty big profile, so try to just go for the enemies again straight on and then wiggle your nose to splash the damage that you take all over your armor that you have, left torso, right torso, and of course the center. We also have some skills here. Okay, we're gonna take a look at that. I definitely wanted to go for a magazine capacity and as much cooldown as possible. I'm skipping heat gen. I don't need that in the build because the light gausses are just heat neutral more or less, and the small lasers are not racking up that much heat. Therefore, we can go for as much cooldown as possible. Laser duration just for the giggles. We are going for maximum survivability here because I wanted to be in the fight for a long time, and as I was saying, you have to be very active if you want to make light Gauss work, and therefore exposing yourself to the enemy, even taking damage in return so that you can dish out a little bit more. We have no operation skilled, obviously, again, no heat management needed, but we are going for 60% radar deprivation and then double artillery strike on top of a UAV. Yeah. And that's the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the two games that are coming. And if you have that, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Grim Plexus, we are playing Conquest, and I want to see if I can get over to the Theta spot and try to punch somebody with my light Gauss rifles. We have 116 shots, and then we are down to the small lasers, but you know, when they are gone, we dealt 1,000 damage if we hit all of that. So, it's gonna be fine. Question is, are we getting into situations where we are reliably shooting our Gauss rifles? Because the rate of fire determines how much damage we deal, not the impact. Each Gauss only deals 8 damage, combined we have 16 damage, and yes, I'm very well aware that this is basically as much as a single regular Gauss rifle does. However, again, the rate of fire gives us more DPS, and yeah, let's see. We want to get somewhere, and we really do not want to play the peeking game. We want to play the stay in the enemy's faces and shoot them all the time game. So, let's see. We need to find some enemies before we can do that. I mean, this is part of the strategy. The shooting part is on my end. The having enemies part is on the enemy's end. And this is a cicada. Oh, I wanted to hit the lag again. There's a hit. Yeah, that doesn't do anything anymore. Okay, and he's out. But that's fine. Actually, it's not fine. It is absolutely not fine. I thought I saw somebody there. Okay, we need to get Theta quickly, because otherwise we will lose the game, and we will not have the time to DPS the enemies down. The Conquest means that we are on a very hard clock. We are on a timer here. So, let's get that thing, and then find ourselves some enemies to fight. Alright, it's 2 and 3 in terms of capture points. We need to get high ground, by the way, because that gives us the overview that we need to shoot the enemies. So let's try to get up here, group up with our teammates, and then shoot the guys that are probably in this area. Why would you move, Mr. Cicada? Why? I should go for the big guys. Easier targets, they're not running away from us so much. And this is the problem. This guy has more stay down power than I have. So we are actually bound. See you. We are bound to peek here. That's not good. That firing line could really, really hurt us. Don't see. I don't see. I don't see. Give me vision. There's a guy. Alright. So we also have a king crab in the back there. Oh, that's awkward. Why is there a king crab still? Again, I try to squeeze out as much DPS as I possibly can. Even shooting my small lasers at range here. Alrighty. Come on, come on, come on. No? Okay. Yeah, we were blocked by a teammate here. That was unfortunate. There's a king crab, I believe? Is it? Cicada dodged down in the last moment. Damn it. And yeah, I know that we are shooting random targets only, which is kind of bad in general. You really need to focus your fire if you want to get something done on the battlefield in general. So, let's see if we can... it's just suppression. Oh man, this is so... I'm so pressured shooting my weapons all the time. Don't hit me. He hit me. On the Kodiak, guys, on the Kodiak! Don't you see what I see? I see an angry bear running towards me. Okay, let's try to focus on the same component at least, so that we can take out his firepower. I know. I'm gonna take the damage in order to take your damage. On the Kodiak, guys, can we kill him, please? The cool thing is that the Bushwhacker is so sturdy. Nice, down he goes, 2 and 3. Keep it up on the King Crab. Where's the King Crab? Center on the King Crab, please. As much as possible. I try to attract the fire. King Crab shut down. Punish him. Let's go. Charlie. Down goes the King Crab. Now back to the center, guys. We need to go to Fox 7, Golf 7 immediately. We need to get kills fast in order to win the game. There's a Thanatos in Golf 7. I'm gonna engage him now. Yeah, seriously. We are on that timer that I was saying earlier. More people here. Bad. But let's see. Thanatos is coming. On the Thanatos. On the Thanatos. Let's kill him. Good job, guys. Marauder is next. Go for Alpha. It's low signal behind us. Or around us. Probably the Cicada. I cannot see. That. Gilly. Okay. Hello, Mr. Gilly. Goodbye, Mr. Gilly. Good, good, good. Keep it up, guys. We need to kill them now. And then we need to cap quickly. Oh, I don't think that it's gonna be enough, though. Let's see. Let's see. 7 and 4. I think we need to get the kills in the next 1 or 2 minutes. Otherwise, we'd lose here. What? Not a kill? Oh, damn it. Alright, Mr. Mistlings. We're gonna get your side torso. And then the arm. And then you're not dangerous anymore. Good. Alright, guys. Fox 7. There was one guy, at least. Also, they have a UAV. Don't care about the UAV. They know that we are coming anyway. Let's go. Yeah, I see the Cicada. I see an Atlas. Cicada needs to go. Come on, Cicada. Ah, he's so low. Come over here, buddy. Down he goes. 11 and 5. Okay, guys. I'm going to... Kappa. Let's see. Can we do it? Make sure that you... If you have a capture point, camp on it so that they cannot get it back. Again, I'm going to Kappa. I really hope that's enough. But yeah, the killing time was really good there. As soon as we made that call, the people were following and we did it. We are down to 30 shots, by the way. So we almost shot all of our firepower out to the enemy. I don't think that is going to be enough, though. So we are so far away. All of us are kind of in the center here. And we still struggle getting even in the proximity of the capture points there. So, yeah. The enemy only needs 100 points. What is that? With 4 capture points, like 30 seconds? Not even? Not gonna make it. Absolutely not. But okay. It was a good fight, though. I really enjoyed that. So, yeah. Light Gauss. If you get into a situation where you can constantly fire at the enemy, it is pretty good, I guess. I didn't even drop my artillery strikes here. And that's actually pretty nice because now we can see how, like... raw weapon damage we dealt. And by the way, for all of you guys who say, ugh, artillery strikes just pad your damage and you just want to show off your high damage score, my videos are not about for me to compare my EPIN with you guys. This is just for me having fun on the battlefield, and if I have an asset at hand that helps me winning the game, then I'm gonna use that, okay? So, for all of you haters out there, there's my answer. Anyhow, we didn't win, sadly. However, we had a good fight, and that, I think, is important for this match here. So let's have a look at the end score. We got 600 damage. I was working so hard here, and quote unquote only got 600, but we got 3 killing blows, 8 assists, and 6 components destroyed. That's your first round. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing Gaustic Valley, we are playing Isolde, and I hope that we can defend Delta 5 because I really like that spot. That's a pretty cool spot. So, yeah, let's see. My Isolde mechs are already pushing into that direction, and that is so much appreciated. I think we have to go for night vision here in order to see anything on the field. But, yeah, I think it's just a way how to go about it here. So, I'll drop that. And now we just regroup, take the high ground, see if the enemies are coming, shoot them while they are doing it, and maybe at some point we're gonna go in their flanks by crossing the caldera, crossing the center, and, you know, then going in their flanks. That's how you do a flanking maneuver, right? You go in their flanks, basically. Target acquired. It's a mauler? What is he doing there? Interesting. Very, very interesting. There's a guy. On the Black Knight. On the Black Knight, Charlie. Okay, 2 solid hits. Right torso is very damaged. And another one. Pretty good. Okay, that was decent, I'd say. I was decent. We didn't take any return fire. This guy got a little bit of damage. Actually, a hell lot of damage. Assault mech there. Assault mech there. Oh, it's just a bushwhacker. Okay. Stalker, though. You want my... Yeah, he wants my life. Okay, I dropped artillery strike on the Stalker. I really hope it hits. And it does. Actually, quite well. Yeah, that was a good strike, honestly. I hit him. We need to hold this line here. Very important. We gotta keep pushing them down. One more. Yeah, it hit again. Oh my god, the pixel shooting at that range. Not that easy. Okay, we hit the dragon. The dragon needs to get hit on the right side, though. Not on the left. And we'll drop a strike. No, we don't drop a strike here. That's a nice push attempt, though. Right side on the Black Knight is crit, by the way. Yeah, I'm dropping the artillery right here. I just want to make them sit there. And then turn around and help out the guys in the back. So, oh, it didn't drop it. Oh, it was on cooldown. Yeah, no, that's fine. Let's kill the Mauler, a Marauder. The thing is that we really don't have to bother with, let's get that Marauder down, the Mauler-rauder. Down he goes, perfect. So, Stormcrow, only a matter of time until he gets destroyed. Maybe not. Oh, maybe he's gonna kill me. Maybe he has the chance to kill me here. Get down. Wow. Nice. 4 and something. You wanna pop up again, mister? You want some? Come get some. Huh? Okay, no. Good. Going in the flanks now. By the way, they still have a dragon out there. Still have a dragon there in Echo 4. It's a bit risky what I'm doing here. I really hope it's not the wrong decision. Yeah, component destroyed. Yeah, that's what I wanted. The left side also of that guy that gets rid of ECM and helps us out in the long run by destroying another mech. So Charlie, that's the Black Knight. Black Knight is one shot. Charlie, please, get him. Pushing in now. Missed my shot, though. Damn. Could have been an easy kill. Charlie, Black Knight, if you see him, kill him. That's a great fight here. I love it. I love the dynamics of that. Kodiak is one shot, please. One shot, Delta. Maybe 2 shot for me. Alright. Down goes the Kodiak. Next up, Hotel. Sun Spider. Sun Spider left leg or right side. New target. Let's get that side torso off him. Cripple him a bit so that he is not that dangerous anymore. Acquired. Stalker center torso, please. I don't need that arm. Who needs arms anyway? Alright. Repositioning. Let's go. They know where I am, so I don't want to be facing them straight head on. Okay. Here we go again. To the nose. That's the spider. Wrong leg, by the way. Then I targeted there. Targeted the right leg. But it didn't matter because my team was just mopping up. That was a good match. That was really nice. GG. Okay, so let's have a look at the end score here. We had 3 killing blows, we had 6 assists, we got 2 kill most damage dealt with 725 damage done, and 9 components destroyed. That was your daily dose for today. I hope you enjoyed it. It was hell a lot of work that I put into this mag. Again, like Gauss rifles, they are extremely situational and I don't like them too much, but here is another light Gauss build because he wanted it. I hope you enjoyed it. As I was saying, if you did, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I hope to see you guys on the battlefield. Goodbye.